Hi there, this is Ranjit, and in this video, I'll show you some of the apps that you can use on Nexus smartphones or phones that come with stock Android to enhance its experience. Just last week, I posted a video on apps that can enhance your Android experience, and quite a few of you have liked it. Here is the link, you can watch that video. But in this video, I'll be specifically talking about apps that you can use on stock Android, for example, phones like Nexus or even Motorola phones to enhance its experience. So let's get on with this one. So here I have my Nexus 6P with me, and I have been using these apps. And the first thing that you see is that I have some quick toggles over here, and quick toggles are really helpful, I would say. Yes, even with Marshmallow, if you just scroll down like this, we have some quick toggles, but these are not that much customizable. For example, if you even just want to disable mobile data, it takes about 3 or 4 taps. So there is this free app that is known as Power Toggles, and again, all these apps that I'm going to show you are available for free from the Google Play Store. So this is the app, and this actually provides this. These are the quick toggles, and you can actually customize them. It's very easy. You can just click over here and add the toggles you want. For example, as you can see, I have 8 in this row, but you can remove stuff and add more. And you can also add a second row if you want. I haven't used the second row, but you can also add a second row if you want. So it's completely customizable. You can even change the colors. And another thing that it provides is that you'll notice this. It says 94. That is the battery percentage. So it also shows us the battery life, and it's very easy. And as you can see, you can use this. And now if I want to toggle my cellular data, I directly go to that setting, and it's way easier and faster to quickly toggle. And that's the same case, and this also works on the lock screen. You can enable it to work with the lock screen, and I really like it. As you can see, it's visible here. And now I also added the sound icon, and if I just tap it, it goes to no sound, vibrate, or sound active. That way you can also adjust the brightness, auto brightness, manual brightness, full brightness, and stuff like that. So it's a very handy app, and it works very well, I would say. I've also added the flashlight, as you can see, and you can enable it, and it works even from the lock screen, location, and Bluetooth settings. So it's completely customizable, and it works very well, I would say. You can access it directly from the notification also. And so this is a free app that is known as Power Toggles, and I like it very much. The next app is, for example, if you have been using other Android phones, they come with some of the phones, for example, LG phones come with clipboard manager, but sadly that's not there on stock Android, but you can enable it again using this handy app. As you can see, this is known as Clip Stack, and as you can see, I can access some of my recent clipboards. For example, let me actually show you the app. Again, it's a free app. It's known as Clip Stack, and it's very easy. These are my, it'll store all these clipboards, and it's a very basic app, and it works very well. And directly from the notification, as you can see, let's say I just want to use this. I can just copy that, and that clipboard is now copied, and I can paste it anywhere I like. For example, if I go to Twitter, I can just go over here, and as you can see, it pasted my signature. That way I can just move around, and let's say this is some other clip what I pasted. So this is a pretty handy app, I would say, as you can see. So it's one of those handy apps, I would say, that will be useful for most Android users, and you can directly access it via this notification, right? If you just use this, it collapses. So that works also very well, and it's a free app. The next app is, with Android Marshmallow, Google has actually removed the gallery app. And so I was looking for a gallery replacement app. Earlier I was using this Quick Pick, which was a free app, but recently I've started using this new one that is known as Piktures. And I would say it's a little bit on the heavier side, but it does offer a lot of features. For example, by default, it'll show you all the pictures that you have taken like this. But if you swipe away like this, it'll show, for example, I use multiple cameras. So it shows that, for example, from what camera I've taken. So sort of folder view. But if you move to this side, and it also shows you via geolocation, as you can see. For example, when I was in Delhi, some pictures that I've taken. So it automatically shows that. So it works very well, in my opinion. Also, you can actually see the pictures via date. So this way, it works very well. And I feel it's much better than the stock photos app now that we have with Google. So you can check out this app that is known as Piktures for gallery app replacement. Next is, again, it's a fact that the camera app on Nexus devices is very bare bones. In fact, the camera on this Nexus 6P is actually very good, but I feel the camera app is very basic. Yes, it might be okay if you're sort of a basic user, but if you know a little bit about photography and stuff, the camera app is very basic, and I would say a third-party camera app does offer a lot of functionality. For example, if you know manual modes and stuff, and I've been playing around with quite a few cameras, and I like this A to Z camera app. This offers a lot of more, control, and you can adjust stuff. It's actually very easy, as you can see. I can change the focus, blurring. I can change the white balance. I can change the ISO, shutter speed, and it works really well. I can just tap, and the default stuff also works. For example, this is the manual mode that I'm using. So if you know a little bit more about camera and stuff, and as you can see, and it's fast. So you can have a look at these camera apps. I also actually like this Cameringo and also the Camera MX app. So again, if you are looking for a camera replacement and you feel the stock Android camera that you get with the Nexus devices is not that great for your needs, you can certainly have a look at these apps, and they do offer you actually a lot of options. So a lot of manual modes and filters and stuff, so you can check them out. So the camera apps that I would say you can check out are the A to Z camera, the Camera MX, even the open camera is pretty good, and this Cameringo. Again, I haven't decided which one I'll be actually using. I actually used this A to Z camera and this Cameringo a lot, and I was satisfied with the results. Next, some of the tools that you can use. Again, these are common tools. For example, for file management, yes, with Android Marshmallow we have a default file manager, but you have to go into the storage tab to access that. For file manager, I'm using this ES File Explorer. It works very well, and it's all again free to use. Also, again, this is not specific to Nexus phones, but I'm using this Glovebox, and you can have your favorite apps over here. So it makes switching between the apps very easy. For example, I can quickly jump between my favorite apps by just tapping over here, and this is done by application known as Glovebox. And you can have this launcher, anywhere on the left, right, wherever you feel, and that is done by application known as Glovebox. So as you can see, it you can put your favorite applications, and that way it works. So I also like Glovebox. Next, for photo enhancements, I would say you can have a look at this AutoDesk Pixlr. It's a very good app. Again, by default, let me just go back. This is how it starts, and you can take a photograph, but you can also go to your gallery and look at other photographs and then edit it out. For example, these are some of the photographs that we took recently. For example, let's take up this photograph, and now we can edit and enhance this photograph. For example, let's try to add some effects. Let's add this effect, and as you can see, you can easily add some beautiful effects to this one. You can add borders and stuff, and it's up to your creativity, I would say, regarding this one. So it works very well, and for example, you can also fix photographs, you can also crop stuff and do manual adjustments. For example, exposure, you can increase the exposure and stuff. So it works really well. So if you're looking for a photo editing app to enhance your photographs and add effects, you can have a look at this AutoDesk Pixlr. It's a very good app in my opinion. Let's just go back, and again, this is I have also replaced the default dialer. Yes, the default dialer is good enough, but I have replaced it with this True Phone dialer, and I won't say it's a must replacement, but I feel it offers a more elegant way to manage your contacts and view your contact. For example, by default it shows you the last five numbers that you have dialed, so it's easy. And again, it does offer a lot of settings also. For example, if you have used Samsung phones, within their contacts, if you just swipe like this, you can
send an SMS, and that is possible with this one. And if you swipe over here, it dials. So very small enhancements like that are possible with this True Phone Dialer. And as you can see in the settings, you can actually customize it. So these were some of the apps that I use on my Nexus smartphone to enhance its experience. I would love to know what are the third-party apps that you use on your Nexus devices or stock Android devices to enhance its experience. Do share your opinion in the comment section below. I hope this video was helpful, and if you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, hit that subscribe button. Thank you. This is Ranjit, and I hope to see you in my next video.